Hi, welcome to Robojax. In this video I'm going to introduce this W1209 temperature control module. This is one of the best module and easy to use module that you can get. It doesn't need anything else like Arduino or anything. It has a temperature sensor, so you can connect it here, and it's about 50 centimeters, so you can control a temperature, and the temperature is shown in real time. And it works with 12 volts, so ground and 12, and then you can connect your AC load, whatever you have, let's say a heater, a fan, or any other device that you want to control with the temperature. So one way to use this one is that you are setting your temperature, the desired temperature, at, let's say, 58 degrees Celsius, and the current room temperature is 20 or 30, whatever is the liquid that you are measuring. So when the temperature reaches at 58, the relay will turn on and will connect your fan, and the fan will blow until the temperature reaches back to the desired lower than desired value, and it will keep the fan off again. So the other way would be to put it the opposite. For example, you have a heater and you want to keep something warm and up to 58 and not more than that. So in that case, this will keep the load on until it reaches to that temperature that you're looking for, let's say 58. When it reaches 58 degrees, it will turn this off, disconnect the load for you. So this can be set very easily. We have now three buttons here. That's a negative, positive, and then set. Now I've connected it to 12 volts, so this is the temperature that is currently showing, the room temperature. So if you disconnect the sensor from the device, you will get LLL, so that also helps you to know that the sensor is disconnected if you're using longer wire. Now, to set a certain temperature, we just press this. It's blinking now. You can go up and down with this, or maybe press it harder. So let's say you want to set it at 80 degrees. So just leave it. It returns back. That is the temperature that you're setting, as simple as that. So I'm going to connect an AC load here to turn the AC load on and off with this one. And after that, I will explain some other features of this for different purpose. So let me explain the AC bulb here. This is a table light that is connected to the wall outlet, and then the wire goes and will be turned on. But I have disconnected one of these two wires here, so let me show you. I've just cut this wire from here. Now this can be connected to the relay. The relay job is to just connect it, so it will be on, and disconnected, it will be off. I've just twisted them and then put some solder, so this can be inserted into a connector with a screw. To connect your load, you will connect the two wires in here. So doesn't matter which one is which, so you just connect the two wires that you're coming. So in my case, I'm gonna connect this here. Now the AC load is connected, so there is a power now going on, and that is the bulb. So I'm just putting it aside so you can see it. I'm using the heat gun to heat this up. And the sensor is here. Let me just, as you saw, to check the temperature that you have set, just press this button, and that's 80 degrees. Okay, so it just disappears. Now I'm heating this up. And just pay attention, at 80 degrees that bulb will turn on. Okay, it just went even 88. It stays on until it reaches some temperature around 80, and around 80, at 80 it will turn off. Pay attention at what temperature it goes off. It should be at 77. Okay. To keep it on, and when it reaches that temperature, it will go off. So let's see, it was 80 degrees, and now I'm applying some temperature, so you can see that it will go off. You see, at 80 it went off, because we use it in the opposite way when we set it to heat. This has another feature that you can set this up. When the temperature goes down, it does not react immediately. You can set, let's say, 2 degrees or 3 degrees, or they call it a backlash. So backlash temperature is the amount of temperature that you set. When it goes down, it should go just below that temperature, then turn off. You can set it at 0 or up to 15 degrees. I set this at 3 degrees, which I'm going to show you. So let's have a look at the specification of this one. It says that the temperature that it can control is from minus 50 to 110 degrees Celsius. The resolution is from minus 9 to 99 at 0.1 degrees Celsius. Above this temperature, it might be a little different, but between these two ranges, it's 0.1 degrees, which is good. The resolution at all temperature is 1 degrees. Above this, it will just jump at 1. You will not see, let's say, 105 point something. So it will go from 105 to 106. The measured accuracy is 0.1. So this is the same thing as a resolution. The control accuracy is 0.1. You can set exact temperature of 0.1 degrees Celsius. Refresh rate is 0.5 seconds. In 1 second, it measures twice. So input voltage is 12 volts, which is very common voltage. That's nice. Measuring input, that is the probe that they use, and with 0.5%. Accuracy. And then waterproof sensor is 50, so waterproof, so that you can submerge this into the liquid or water. And then one channel up to 10 ampere. So this is very important, that you cannot put a heavy load through this. And this will, in a static, it will consume 35 milliampere, and when it's turned on, it's up to 65 or less than 65. It has some other features. As some code that will show on the screen, it shows P0, 1, 2, 3, up to 5. Now let's have a look at this one. This is setting P0, heat and cool. Let's say you want to set this that in normal operation, you will set it such that when the temperature reaches a certain value, the fan will start working. So this is one way. The relay will be disengaged, the connection will not be established. The other way would be that initially this will be on like a heater, and when it reaches certain temperature, the heater will shut off, so this will be disconnected. So let's set that one. Hold this button for more than a few seconds, like 4 or 5 seconds, and you will see the P on the screen. Now it's P. When it goes to P, then you can press this short, that's cold, and then you can change it, heat or cold. Now pay attention, when I set it to heat and exit, the light will go on. Now when it exits, just wait. So by default, as if this is a heater and I want to keep it on, and when it reaches that temperature, it will go off. So let's see, it was 80 degrees, and now I'm applying some temperature, so you can see that it will go off. You see at 80 it went off because we use it in the opposite way when we set it to heat. So you see it. Let me change that P back to cold. Hold it and wait. P0 heat and then change it to cold. And exit, wait for it to change. So now it's changed. Now let's set the P1, the backlash as they call it, so hold this. Press now again, press this plus button, P1. Now when you're in P1, go and set it 3 degrees. So you can set it exactly at 0, 3, or 4, or whatever you want. You cannot set it at 0, it can be set at 0.1, which is 1/10 of a degree. Now let's set the upper limit, P2, hold this again. When you see P, go 1, 2, and then press this to set it. The upper limit is 90 degrees, so you can change it to whatever you want. P3, lower limit. Now I'm going to the P3, the lower limit, so that is 30. Let's say you don't want to go below 30, so it will be always showing 30. And now again, let's see that for the correction, P4. When you're in P4, set the correction is now 0, or you can say minus or plus some value. Exit. Now press P5. That is a delay. When it's turned on, you can set it. Here it's now set at 0, but you can set it at, let's say, that this is in minutes. 6 minutes after the change happened, it can react. But let's make it 0 so it can react immediately. And then 6, that's the alarm. When you set the alarm, go here. The alarm is now off. If you set the alarm on with this, this will go with, and after that, press this, it will give you the temperature for that alarm. So now it's set at 66. When it reaches at 66, you will see the alarm. Let me turn that on. There will be a 3 dash on the screen. So that is the trigger of alarm. So it will not allow the relay or anything to work if you set the alarm value. And this will go back to normal when the temperature reaches below 66. So if I hold this, my body temperature will reduce it. Oh, it's hot. Yes. This device is made very versatile. The relay, the contacts. If you look here on this side, they've been soldered very well. You connect it, you know that this will not rip this connector off. So it's very nicely done. We have 4 screws if you are mounted on somewhere. The only worry is that there's a switch or such that if you want to cover it, you need another mechanism to make sure that you are able to touch and make adjustments. So these are not in a good position, but it's very cheap. You can get it from eBay or AliExpress and it can do the job perfectly. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video, share it, and also subscribe to get updates of my upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.